out of here. Oh, hello there, Macattack here, and we are back in our Rebel in York hangar to do yet another Star Citizen ship review. Today we are doing the ANVL Gladiator. Now this one to me has gone under a lot of changes since its initial design. It originally looked a lot more like something you'd see out of Elite Dangerous, with a lot more of a geometric triangular design. Right now, it looks to me like this is the Grandpa Hornet, in my opinion. This is honestly Mr. Grandpa Hornet. It is big, it is tough, it's a little slow, but it's honking tank. And look at those two little thrusters right there. I mean, this thing is well armored. This thing is basically meant to do torpedo and bombing runs, so it has a heap load of ordnance and such on it. Let's see here, we have missile place here, cooler, gun, turret, gun, power, two, size 2 power plant, more ordnance. I mean, this thing carries a lot of big, big punches to it, and it shows when you're flying. And on top of that, it can take a beating. It's got a turret gun up there for if you have a friend. One of the interesting things about this ship is how we actually enter it. And unlike other ships where you have to go through the side, this one you have to go through the nose. I'm not really certain how this works with, I guess when the landing gear comes up, you're going to be an pressurized atmosphere, but if we can get in there, there we go. That worked, right? That didn't work. Can we try this again? It's a little awkward to get in sometimes. I am a professional. There we go. Here it goes. It goes down with the landing gear, and we can get in it this way. Come on. Unless, of course, it glitches, then we can't. Oh, there it goes. There it goes. Slow animation. And my head's kind of on backwards, but oh well. Let's go on up. This is Alpha, people. Now, again, this cockpit looks like the Grandpa of Hornets. You can see how it has more of its... It's a little more old tech, in my opinion, than the Hornet was with the stuff up here. It's very sort of base. Your gunner's back there somewhere. But yeah, you have everything you need. You have your state of the ship right there. You have your gun set up with a little low down to see. You have your current target, your weapon power. I wish they could actually switch the gun point and your power plant thing, because I mean, just for my personal preference, that's how I tend to fly. But yeah, it's got everything you need and it's pretty good visibility. Now, I will say up front that while I really have a lot of respect for the ship for what it does, for my personal playstyle, it's not really for me. It's probably the ones I'm thinking of trading in the most. But yeah, let's see how it flies. And I'll talk about that later as we see how it flies. Until then, hang in there. Alright, here we are in the ANVL Gladiator out in space. And we have the nice little cockpit. Take a look around. Make it nice and pretty. Let's see what it looks like outside. And boom. There we go. Nice and back. And here we are. We look nice and taunting. Not the same colors as the Hornets. Got the same original colorations. Now let's go and kill some hostiles. Let's see how we hold up in combat. Okay. Doesn't seem to have as delicate of a... hard to turn around to. Okay. Doesn't seem to have as delicate of controls or the ability to target as well as that the Hornet did. But let's see how the power goes. Yeah, you can feel right away this is definitely a tank. This is a tank in space. You can't really turn fast in this. This is the giant space turtle right now. Actually, no. Technically, I can't remember what it's called. There's another one coming out that's going to be the space turtle. But this is a turtle in its own right. All right. Come on. You know, I'm actually going to be getting pretty good hits on this guy. It's a little harder to aim at him because of the speed of turning and such. But yeah, this guy actually does some pretty nice damage. And come on. You missed that turning ability though. An ability to change your speed as well. There we go. Oh, Vixen! How could you? Alright, well, I'll take this one then. 465 top speed, and it's not really great, but it's decent. Okay. Let's see here. Come on, let's hit you in the face. I mean, I feel like this is going to be the one that basically you're not really going to be keeping up. Like, this is probably a very bad one against a race, any kind of racing ship. But if you're against a slower ship, I think this is going to do some pretty decent damage. Especially when we get the bombs and such in it. Because this is basically a giant missile boat. Alright, I'm gonna go down. It's a little hard to line up. And one more. And, oh come on, a little more. Again, you can't really see your targeting screen while you're flying, so it's a little hard to tell what we're going at. I think if you had the live tracking on this, it would probably be a little easier. Or just like 20 screens. Guy is not gonna come down for me, is he? There he goes, finally. Okay. Now, we only have laser guns, so we didn't use up any ammo, which is nice. Okay. Level 2, here we go. Trying to get us up to A-burn. Hopefully this goes a little faster. Again, it's not a very maneuverable ship. But I don't think that is where its prime is. Okay. Come on. There we go. Now we're getting... Now we're gonna hang this thing. It's got some pretty good distance shots. It's got some decent distance shots, which is nice. And let's get this guy now. If you can close the distance and keep a nice, like they don't dodge too much, you can take them down pretty fast. But if they start dodging, it's a little hard to keep up with them. So I wouldn't suggest this if you're a solo fighter, but if you're going with a team, I think this is gonna be one that you're gonna wanna have on your team. Okay, Vixen stole that one. Oh, there you are. Stop trying to hit me. There. Okay, good. It's Warlord, but I'm not gonna complain about that. Now time for the big test. A-burn! It took 5 minutes. It's not... Okay, about 6 minutes, basically. It's not as bad as it could have been, but, you know, getting to level 3. Compared to the Hornet just went so fast. There we go. A-burn, let's take you down fast. Let's just set off all the missiles. Let's see how good a bomb ship can bomb. Alright. And there we go. Oh, we have one more. Oh, he dodged that? Oh, come on. Okay, good. And he dodged that one as well. Let's shoot another one just in case, for good measure. There we go! That was perfect. Okay. Yeah, pretty good missiles. Again, your Harpoon's gonna be lining up the shots since you can't really turn very well. The nice thing about this, though, is that I'm taking a lot of hits, and I'm barely even feeling it here. I mean, like, this thing is a tank. This thing is a tank in space. So, that's basically the Gladiator, and you know what? It's a bit of a clunker. I don't think it's good for my flight style, but I can really appreciate where it's coming from. It's nice, it's slow, yes, but it's a tank, and it's got good power behind it. It can carry a lot of ordnance, and I think it's going to be a very good addition to anyone who's going to do strike teams. I think that anyone who's going to like try to make attacks on bigger ships or fight in big parties, this is going to be maybe about... a third of your group you're going to want to have these guys in. Maybe about a quarter. So what do you guys think of the Gladiator? Are you guys interested in the Gladiator? Tell me what you guys think in the comments down below. Like, subscribe, tell everyone about it, and like always, keep on flying.